We're going to talk more about the social ills in a bit, but first, as in the proliferation of illegal drugs and the syndicates behind it, I mean, globally, you talk to analysts, you talk to intelligence officers, they're going to say that you can whittle it down to maybe 3-4 cartels, right, in terms of the drug trade, illegal drug trade. For this one, for example, talk about human trafficking, modern-day slavery, talk about the Chinese connection. Do you have at least an idea as to who is behind this and how many groups really are there?
We have a general sense na batay sa testimonies and affidavits ng mga victim survivors, they all, well, bukang bibig ng lahat nila so far, Chinese bosses daw. Now, are we talking about one syndicate or several? It seemed, for example, dun sa Pastilla scam na halos iisang sindikato yan, medyo centralized. It's seeming now in the ongoing investigation that the syndicate or syndicates engaged in human trafficking and crypto scamming may be more than one. Maaring mas decentralized ang operations na ito. Will that make it easier or harder to rescue the victim survivors and to crack down on these syndicates? That remains to be seen. Pero kung intertwined nga sila sa iba pang mga criminal syndicates, including those trafficking in drugs, eh di hindi talaga madali, because the operations not just of different countries' bureaus of immigration but also law enforcement agencies, kasama na yung ating PNP, yung ating NBI, with whom or who I wish to thank, no, for constantly participating in our hearings, helping us stop the super scamming operations that happen even in our own country. Pero hindi pa ito tapos. Our committee will call another hearing on this, and we will continue to rely on these regulatory and law enforcement agencies to root out the roots of this problem and the syndicates that are creating them.
Okay, final question, Madam Senator, because I know you're going to head off to another meeting. But first, do you have reason to believe? I mean, you've been on this issue for quite a while now. Do you think that this is actually novel? This is actually a new issue to the authorities who are supposedly following this up and making sure that this is not happening? Do you think this is a new thing? Do you think that every single issue that you have unearthed is actually a new thing to them? Or do you think that they've known this for quite a while now?
That's a really good question. Historically, sinasabi, for example, that, you know, we started with pogo-related prostitution, that unfortunately they say prostitution is the oldest business in the world, and, you know, I stand in solidarity with our sister prostituted women seeking to have better life, decent livelihood, healing for themselves and their families. But when you link up prostitution with gambling, also not a recent phenomenon, at kapag ka idinagdag mo pa yung elemento ng collusion of government agencies or government personnel, it makes it all the more painful and certainly not something new, I believe, to the eyes of our authorities. Sinimula naming investigahan yung pogo-related prostitution under the previous administration and previous administrations of leaderships in the agencies, including the Bureau of Immigration. At habang tinalakay namin yung illegal recruitment and detention hanggang sa Pastilla scam, tumawid na tayo sa kasalukuyang administrasyon where our committee has been unearthing these different terrible aspects of human trafficking and crypto scamming operation. So, imposibleng bago ito sa kaalaman ng ating mga otoridad, which makes them all the more accountable at lalong inaasahan dapat to once and for all crack down on this. And one important and definitive step that could be taken even by the current administration, Carmina, is simply collect on the taxes owed government by the POGOs, shut down their operations, and kick them out of the country.
Senator Risa Ontiveros there joining us this noon. Thanks again for your time. Really appreciate it. Take care.